leader of the opposition for a statement, and I now give the floor to the designated speaker for the NFP, the Honourable Lenora Dalyatumbul. You have the floor, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Firstly, I want to thank the Honourable Minister for his speech today, and also thank him and NDMO and the Ministry on behalf of my friends in the deaf community. Thank you for the inclusivity for employing Fiji Sign Language interpreters during the lead-up to and in the wake of Tropical Cyclone Harold. It is we're very, very grateful. Mr. Speaker, I've been to Kandabu three times since the lockdown was lifted, travelling as far as the village of Namachiu on Bambadewa, or the south side, and to Nangalotu on the Bambatokalau, or the north side of the main island. And 2 weeks ago, when I was in my village, we were visited by the barge, the MV Wunilangi, carrying cyclone relief items that were gratefully received by many families. I understand the barge was one of two sent by government to Kandabu to deliver relief items. One of the items that was being handed out and very happily received by the villagers was a little wood-burning stove about so big. And upon inquiry, I was told that these stoves were donations from a Korean company. So I want to join the Honourable Minister in thanking the Australian and New Zealand governments and all the other governments who answered our request for help and those who came to our aid without us asking for help. To the companies, the groups, organizations, both local and from overseas, who donated foodstuff, tents, stoves, and other relief supplies to government in order that government can deliver relief supplies in the wake of Tropical Cyclone Harold, thank you from the bottom of our hearts. This is what friends are for. A friend in need is a friend indeed. Mr. Speaker, it is therefore a little bit painful to see people reminding us that only 3 years ago, the Honourable Prime Minister was demanding that Australia and New Zealand get out of the Pacific Islands Forum because they were not Pacific Islanders as a precondition to him attending the forum.
Order, order, order.
Mr. Speaker, we'd like to find out how many families have accessed their FNPF to help them buy rebuilding materials. How many family members of those who are not FNPF members have been allowed to withdraw money from their fund to help rebuild the lives of their relatives in the villages? The expectation of the people are very high. Farmers need crop rehabilitation in the form of seedlings, not so much seeds. What happened to AgriCare, SugarCare, the various care programs that were rolled out in late April 2018? To end, Mr. Speaker, I wish to invite the Honourable Minister to please go and visit the village of Narikoso in the Tikino of Ono in Kandabu. This village was one of the first to be relocated in government's climate change mitigation plans, with a few homes built on the relocation site. All of these homes were extensively damaged by Tropical Cyclone Harold. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
I thank the Honourable Dalyatumbul for her statement. We will move on, and I now call upon the Minister for Agriculture, Waterways and Environment, the Honourable Dr. Mahendra Rai, to deliver his statement. You have the floor, sir.
Mr. Speaker, sir.